His what? He did. He had holes in his shorts. And he had a lot of green on his shoes. Because he had holes in his shorts, all the children, they laughed and called him names. And they wouldn't let little Johnny play in any reindeer games. It's a long song. I really like Christmas. And they wouldn't let Johnny play any games. And one of the names they called Johnny because of the holes, they called it Cheerios. And one day his teacher, she had heard all the children picking at him. And she said, Johnny! What did she say?
Johnny!
And Johnny walked over and he looked at the teacher out of his eyeballs coming
from. Yeah, that's all right.
And she said, son, I know it hurts you. You put all the children back and didn't catch it. He said, teacher, hey, you never ate any chewed gums. And she said, well, yeah, Johnny, I made a few of them all the time. And Johnny said, well, teacher, haven't you noticed how when you push the materials at the bottom of the bowl, I made a jar right back to the top? I think he told his teacher something like this.
What
did he say? You got me Cheerios.
That's alright.
Cheerios. Why you can touch me till the bottom of the bottle. And now rise to the top. Now that you know it, you asked for it, sing it. You can call me Cheerios. Cheerios. Why you can push me to the bottom of the bowl. And now rise to the top. Sometimes when I do this, I'm a little ghetto. Because my friend that actually wrote that song was ghetto. And it's a very serious imitation song that they use in their group. And I just messed it up for about 3 years. And I did all that sing stuff. But they sing it real high. So in honor of the Nation Brothers Gospel Quartet, we'll do it real high. You ready?
You can call me Cheerios. Oh, Cheerios. Cheerios. Cheers now, push me to the bottom of the bowl, and now rise to
the... Okay, the men stand up in the auditorium. All men. Okay, men, look around. Here's the deal. I got to take this back into a little fact check. Some of you over here. Me and Mrs. and in your own church, we'll look around. Second floor, you can find out the men. You guys, if you don't learn this thing, you'll be just like the rest of them. You'll be a loser dad. So let's learn this thing right now. You ready? Guys, real high. You ready? Let's show them where we're at. Here we go, guys.
You can call me Cheerios.
Hey girls, why don't you tell them by clapping how much, really truly girls, you want a man that's willing to stand up for God? That very same day, Johnny, he run home from school. He run down the sidewalk and into the hood and in the door and up the stairs straight into his bedroom.
I
was great. And he took off his shirt and he got with the magical markers. And he started writing on the back of his. He did. And about that time, his mama, she done busted her through. And she hollers.
Johnny!
She screams real loud.
Johnny!
He said, yes, ma'am. She said, well, what are you doing? He said, mama, we get to school. I'm sure the teacher will do good. All right, label was strong. Cheerios will pay me.
Johnny!
He said, I know that, Mama. I think he told his mom something like this. You call me Cheerios. Cheerios. Push me to the bottom of the bowl. And now rise to me. And the moral of the story is this, ladies and gentlemen. The next time you have a bad hair day, your pantyhose don't fit. Your favorite shoes or somebody else's. Or your boyfriend is now someone else's boyfriend. Or your girlfriend. She don't even like boys anymore. The next time when mamas aren't being mamas and daddies aren't being daddies, you stuff the stuff and just say,
you can call me Cheerios, Cheerios. You can push me to the bottom of the road, and I'll rise to you.